Natalie Randolph is a high school science teacher with a finely developed sense of the psychology of teenage boys.
You have to prove yourself?
No.
No? You have to prove how tough you are?
No, they have enough fun proving how tough they are with each other.
That keeps them busy?
That keeps them busy long enough. All the way down. All the way up.
Randolph, 32, is slightly built and has a high-pitched voice, but she is plenty tough.
Oh. All the way up!
Pain doesn't hurt.
So what? Pain is weakness leaving the body.
Go!
Tough enough, in fact, to be head football coach at Coolidge High School in Washington, D.C.
Come on, keep going, keep going, keep going, come
on. She's believed to be the only woman in the country to hold such a position. And that put her in the media spotlight when she took the job nearly 3 years ago.
While I'm proud to be part of what this all means, being female has nothing to do with it. I love football. I love football. I love teaching. I love these kids.
The attention only grew last year as Randolph coached her team into the city's championship game, the annual Turkey Bowl played on Thanksgiving. Randolph grew up in Washington, graduated from the University of Virginia, and played football herself for 6 years with the D.C. Divas, a professional women's league. But if she's passionate about football and focused on winning, she's also quite clear about priorities. Football as a means towards staying and excelling in school.
Academics come first, and you know, we always, all of my coaches, we always preach to them, when you get our age, you won't be playing football. So, you know, we like to think we have a lot of life to live, so you will too, and you need to prepare for that. Football is kind of just icing on the cake.
How do you break it down? Mm-hmm. I'm one of your kids here, right?
Right.
And I just want to go out and practice.
Well,
I don't want to go study.
We tell them, you know, you have to be a whole person. You have to be smart. You know, you're not going to be very effective on the football field if you're not smart and if you're not good at studying, analyzing things. These colleges, you know, they have hundreds of applicants to choose from, hundreds of players to choose from that are just as big, just as strong, just as fast. And what's going to set you apart is your character and your academics.
Part of being a whole person, she says, graduating from high school. As elsewhere around the country, that's a major problem in the city where Randolph teaches. The high school graduation rate in Washington, D.C. last year was under 60%. And like public school teachers elsewhere, she sees the realities facing many of her students.
Their responsibilities at home and outside of school, sometimes that will pull them away. They, you know, figure that it's easier for them to get a job at this point so that they can sustain whatever needs to be sustained and they, you know, don't come back to school. Or some of them are so far behind, you know, academically, they get very frustrated and it's like, well, why bother?
All athletes at Coolidge are required to attend a 1-hour, 15-minute study hall Monday through Thursday before practice begins.
Who messed you up? Nobody messed you up but you. You earned them grades.
Randolph and two other teachers run the session, hitting their student athletes over the head with the football facts of life.
When the college coaches come here and they ask me what your GPA is, they're not worried about the GPA on here, on your transcript that says cumulative GPA. They're not worried about that. What they're worried about is your GPA of these combined 16 courses.
She also mentors her charges in a variety of other ways.
Might come to her when I'm having trouble in a class. She talk with me. Don't give up. Keep pushing through it. Like in life, everything's not gonna go your way.
She all wants us to succeed and like go to college to the next level. Even if it's not football wise, like if it's academic wise, she still wants us to be there.
Randolph's success on and off the field has attracted praise from local leaders.
You need to have a full array of opportunities that are going to attract kids. And certainly, interscholastic athletics like this is one of the best dropout and truancy prevention programs we can possibly have.
She's really shown how to leverage the football team to keep these young men, you know, on the straight path, but also to graduate from high school.
We need to do it, you got to turn your shoulder.
One former player, Chuck Gaines, is now at Shaw University in North Carolina. He credits Randolph with getting him there.
My grades improved from a C average to a B. When I was being coached by Coach Randolph, like she pushed academics hard. So it was school first, then football. Because you know, majority of kids nowadays always focus on sports.
For Gaines, who spent much of his childhood moving from one homeless shelter to another, Randolph also taught him important life lessons.
It's always something I will remember that she always told me that helped me do everything. If it's not hard, it's not worth it. When I'm in class and I got a big paper to write, I always go to her. She'll always tell me that. She'll always tell me that. If it's not hard, it's not worth it.
You know, it sounds sappy, but if they know that you love them, they will work. And if they know that you care about what they're going through and understand what they're going through, they'll work. Nose of the ball should be in between these two fingers. And they make mistakes, they fall, you pick them back up again, you show them what they did wrong, they fix it, and they do it again, and eventually they get it. In the end, they always get it.
You used the word sappy. I'm thinking of football, which is a violent, tough. On the football field, you gotta show how tough you are.
Oh, yeah.
And here you are talking about love.
Mm-hmm.
You don't see a disconnect?
No, I mean, they will go out there and they'll run into each other and hit and whatever they need to do. And that's not the hard part about it. They need to know that they're gonna be cared for in order to make that sacrifice. They need to know they're not making that sacrifice for nothing.
In fact, life on the field got harder this year for Randolph and the Coolidge Colts. The good news, more than 20 seniors from last year's team graduated. The bad news, that left a much younger and less experienced group behind. The team went 3-9 this season and won't be playing in the Turkey Bowl, leaving Natalie Randolph, the teacher, sounding like football coaches everywhere.
Yeah, it sucks to lose. Every coach wants to win, right? I want to win. Some games we could have won, you know.
Still, success here is measured in many ways. And Coolidge's young players did end their season with a victory.